Good morning, my dear students. Let us discuss about business law class 2. Today, contents of our business law class 2 is operant acceptance, free consent, capacity consideration. Offerant acceptance. An offer is a proposal made by one person to another. Here, an offer is a proposal which is made by one person to another. The person making the offer is known as offerer. The person who is making the offer is called offerer or proposer or promiser. And the person whom the offer is made is called offeree. Promisee or proposee. The offer for whom it is made, those are called as offeree, promisee or propose. And coming to the second point, acceptance may be defined as an assent or agreement of offeree to the offer. Here, coming to the contract concept, before going into the contract, an agreement will be happen. Here, before the agreement, there will be two party people will be there, party A and party B. Here, party A will be brings in one offer to the party B. Then party B will accept that offer. Then the agreement will be happens. And legality support will be added to the that agreement. Then that agreement is converted into the contract. So, before converting into a contract, every contract should have the offer and acceptance elements. And coming to the example, if L says to M, will you purchase my car for rupees 10,000, then he is said to have accepted L's offer. Coming to the example, L says to the M, will you purchase my car for 10,000 rupees? Then he is said to have accept the L's offer. Here, two parties we are having. First party is L, second party is M. Here, offer is brought by the L, party L. And here that offer is accepted by the second party, that is M. What is the condition is purchasing a car for the rupees of 10,000. Here L is willingly given offer and M is also accepting the offer willingly. There is no any force or any non-legal activities. So law is completely supporting and business is also selling the car. It is also legalized business. So this agreement is converted into the contract. And next point, an offer which is made by the expressing the words are spoken or written is called an expression offer. An offer may be also implied from the behavior of the parties. Any contract should have the three types of condition. One is spoken or written or behavior. When the spoken and written and behavior, any one of the should want to satisfy by the contract, then only the contract is valid. Here, one of the party is asking offer. He is saying the offer to the another party. That is, here the which media they are selected? They are selected the spoken media. They are asking the oral. They are giving the offer in a oral way. So, oral way is also one of the expressive method. And second method is written method, means documentation method. And third method is behavior. So when one person is giving the offer, another person is not willing to accept, he is not giving any reply or any attention towards the first person voice, that is called he is not having the interest. So that is the by behavior also we can understand the contract is accepted and contract is not accepted. That is called expressing the contract. Previous class we have discussed about expressing the contract. Coming to the example of behavior of a parties here, thus if APSRTC runs a bus on a particular route, it is an implied offer. Here APSRTC runs a bus on a particular route. It is an impaled offer. Any person may accept. This is impaled offer. Here previously the condition is given that the particular route only the bus will be travel. If you are interested, you can join. If you are not interested, you can leave the offer. That is called impaled offer. And offer may also be classified as general offer or specific offer. When an offer is made to define person, it is called specific offer. And when an offer is made to the world at large, it is called general offer. Here offer is classified into two categories. First one is specific offer and general offer. Specific offer means it is specifically asked by a single person, particular person. That is called specific offer. Here second one is general offer. General offer means the offer is given to the world at a large content. That is called general offer. Free consent, second concept. Free consent is consisting five different types of elements: coercion, undue influence, fraud, misrepresentation, and mistake. Coercion, undue influence, fraud, and misrepresentation, mistake. Coercion means force. Undue influence means dominating. Fraud means cheating. Misrepresentation means malpractice. And mistake. These are the five important elements. To completely over the free consent, these five elements should be satisfied in the contract. Then only the contract will be free consent. Then that contract is valid contract. Free consent. Free consent means here the some matter is there. It should be understood by the both parties of the contract in a similar manner. Here some communication is there. This communication should be understood by the both parties of the contract in a similar manner. That is called consent. When there is a free consent only, that contract is valid. Means it should be free from the coercion, undue influence, fraud, misrepresentation, mistake. Coming to the concept means offer and acceptance are vital to valid contract. Here offer and acceptance are vital to a valid contract. Any valid contract contains two important elements is that is offer and acceptance. The acceptance or consent of a parties must be fair. Here offer and acceptance should be considered be a fair. Consent can be defined as an act of assenting to an offer. Two or more persons are said to consent when they are agree upon the same thing in the same manner. Here once again headlines means two or more persons are said to consent when they are agree upon the same thing in the same sense. And consent is said to be free if approval of parties is not affected by coercion, undue influence, fraud, misrepresentation, and mistake. Here there is a contract. The contract is consisting two different parties, party A and party B. Here the communication is understood by both parties of the contract in a similar manner. That is called consent. Here there is no any misrepresentation or fraud, mistake, undue influence, coercion. When these are all free, then it is called a free consent. Then that contract is a valid contract. Coming to the coercion. Coercion is a committing or threatening to commit any act for the forbidden by the Indian Penal Code 1860. Here coercion is a committing to threatening or to commit any act forbidden by the Indian Penal Code Act 1860. Here IPC 1860 Act is there. Here some points are forbidden. Forbidden means banned. Here one of the party in the contract is willingness to do threatening and committing to the do false type of activities, illegal activities, which are banned by the Indian Penal Code 1860, are unlawful detaining or threatening to detain any property to produce of any person with the intention of
getting the approval of the party to a contract. Here, once some force is applicable to the from one party of the contract to the another party of the contract to accept that contract, some force is there. That force is called coercion. When a person is compelled to enter into a contract by use of force, the other party are under a threat coercion is said to be employed. Thus, committing or threatening to commit any act forbidden by the Indian Penal Code 1860, unlawful detaining or threatening any property is called coercion. And coming to the second one, undue influence. Sometimes a party is compelled to enter into an agreement against his will as a result of unfair persuasion. By the other such cases, undue influence is said to be exercised according to section 16. Here some force is there, here one contract is there, there are two different parties, party A and party B. Is party A is forcing to the party B. When after entering into the contract, the party A is showing the dominating nature towards the party B in the contract. Such type of activity is called undue influence. Defines undue influence means as a contract is said to be induced by undue influence where the relations subsisting between the parties are such that one of the parties is in a position to dominate the will of the other, uses that position to obtain an unfair advantage over the other, an unfair advantage over to the other. Relations which raise presumptions of undue influence, the following relationships which raise presumptions of the undue influence are following relations usually raise a presumption of undue influence, which are guardian, ward, trustee, beneficiary, religious advisor, discipline, doctor and patient, parent and child, financier, fiancé and fiance, and solicitor and client. Here, when we want to protect the one of the contractor, one of the party in the contract, we can protect by the help of guardian, ward, trustee, beneficiary, religious advisor, discipline, doctor and patient, parent and child, fiance and fiancee, solicitor and client. Here solicitor means a advocate, lawyer. Fraud. There must be a representation and it must be false. There must be a concealment of a material fact or only a partial statement of a fact such that making the stated fact false. Here some fraud is there. Must be a representation and it must be false. Here there is some representation, but that representation is not at all true. It is completely fake. It is a false statement. There must be a concealment of material fact. Here the original, the natural data is hidden. And only partial statement of a fact such that making the stated the fact false. They are making the false data. The representation must be made before the conclusion of the contract with the intention of inducing the other party to act upon it. Here one of the party in the contract intentionally doing the fraud to do the damage to the other party of the contract. The representation of a statement must have been made with a knowledge of falsity. They are willing to do the falsity without belief in the truth or recklessness, not caring whether it is true or false. Here some people are doing the mistake by recklessness of their behavior without knowing it is true or false. The other party must have induced act upon representation or assertion. The other party must have relied upon the representations and must have been deceived. The other party acting on the representations or assertion must have subsequent suffered some loss. Here there will be some loss to the second party of the contract because first party of the contract is using the fraud techniques. Coming to the misrepresentation. Representation is a statement of fact which one party makes in the course of negotiations to another with an intention to induce the other party to enter into a contract. Representation is statement of fact which one party makes in the course of negotiations to another with an intention to induce the other party enter into a contract. Here one party is willingly doing the misrepresentation to do the damage of the second party of the contract. Intentionally they are inducing the other party to enter into the contract. Representation may be expressed by the words spoken or written or implied from the behavior of the parties. Here representation is can be shown by words or written or implied behavior of their parties. And a representation when wrongly made either innocently or intentionally is a misrepresentation. Here misrepresentation is done by the innocently or intentionally, it is a wrong. An innocent or unintentionally misrepresentations, an intentional, deliberate or willful misrepresentation with intent to deceive or defraud the other party. Misrepresentation means false data is there. So it is willingly done or not willingly done, intentionally done. It is a bad thing in the law. Here no legality support to the misrepresentation of a party. It is a invalid contract. Mistake. The mistake may be defined an enormous belief about something, may be mistake of law or mistake of fact. Here two types of mistakes are there, mistake of law and mistake of fact. Mistake of law is divided into two categories. Mistake of law of the country means mistake of law of our country and mistake of law of the foreign country. And second category, mistake of fact means bilateral mistake and unilateral mistake. Every contract there will be two different parties. The mistake is happening one side of the party of the contract is called unilateral mistake. When the mistake is taken by the both parties of the contract is called bilateral mistake. Capacity and consideration. Before entering into the contract, we want to check that every party of the contract having the capacity and consideration. Here minor, the first thing we want to remember that minor should not enter into a contract. There is no legality support to do contract with minor. Minors. An agreement with or by a minor is a void and an inoperative. An agreement which is done by the minor is a void. It is not valid and it is a inoperative method. He can be a promise or a beneficiary. He can be as a promise or a beneficiary. His agreement cannot be ratified by him in attaining the age of majority. Until he gets the majority age, his contract is not at all ratified. And if he has received any benefit under a void agreement, he cannot be asked to the compensate for it. If he gets any benefit or from the void agreement, he cannot be have rights to ask to compensate for it. And he can also plead minority. There can be no specific performance of agreements entered by a minor as they are void from starting to end. So a minor should not want to participate in any type of the contract. There is no legality support until when he gets the major age, then only he will be have the rights to participate in the contract. Here there is no legality support from starting to ending of the contracts by the minors, and he cannot enter into a contract of partnership. He cannot enter into a contract of partnership, and he cannot be adjusted insolvent. He is a liable of necessities. He can be an agent. He can be an agent. He is not responsible for any insolvency in the business or in the contract. His parents are not at all liable. The contracts entered into by him. Here, minority people, parents are not having liability to enter into contract or as a guardians of their contract also. Persons of unsound mind means lunatics, idiots, drunken persons are expressly declared as an incompetent to a contract. Lunatics means the people who is not having a proper mental condition. The people who are not having a proper mental condition is called lunatics. These people are not eligible for the perform the contracts. And idiots and drunken people means alcohol people and some misbehavior people also not having eligibility to perform the contract. These persons are expressly declared as incompetent to the contract. Persons disqualified by the law to the contract means alien enemies, foreign sovereigns, corporation, insolvents and convicts. Here aliens are present at the another planet. So these people are disqualified by the law of the contract. And foreign sovereigns means foreign country administrators, prime ministers and presidents. These people are not having the qualification to participate in the law of the contract. And the corporation is also not having eligibility. Insolvents, some people will do the IP means insolvency petition. These people should not have the right, or these people are disqualified from the law to the contract. Coming to the convicts. Convicts mean criminal people and thieves are not having the qualification to participate in the law to the contract. This is about the capacity of the consideration. Thank you, my dear student. Please subscribe my YouTube channel.